Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hey fish family, welcome back to Tabarak Aquatics. I am Ross, and this is not my fish room. It's not my basement. This is the inside of my car, and I know y'all see my jacket and stuff like that in the back seat. I just wanted this to be authentic, not all prissy and prim. We're on the road doing a fish store tour of a shop called Nemo Aquarium here in Lawrenceville, Georgia. It's pretty nice. I've been there. He used to own a shop closer to my house, and he closed it down to open up a much better shop and finally a worthy store to do a proper fish store tour. All right, y'all. So hold tight. Here we go. All right, y'all, there we go, Nemo Aquarium. This is the front of his business, Nemo Aquarium. I fell in love with this place real fast. All right, we're gonna approach the door. So I'm gonna try to not disturb anybody in here shopping. They have a right to their privacy. So it's gonna be real brief, and I'm gonna, here we go, y'all. Okay, right away, as you come in, you are greeted by this big tank full of very large, beautiful discus fish. Look at it. Now, Aaron, I remember he always had beautiful discus display tanks in his shop. So this is one of his things. He always kept beautiful discus display tanks. Look at that, gorgeous. So this is one of the few places that not only keep discus fish, but keep large, beautiful, healthy discus fish. It's not all peppered up and everything, okay? Please forgive my sound and everything. I'm trying to not disturb anybody. I think that one is called a cobalt blue, but I don't know my discus that much. All right, fish family, I am having some problems with my camera, so I had to switch to the iPhone. So hopefully iPhone, this is you, and you better come through for me. But anyway, more discus. Like I said, he always had beautiful, large. Look at the quality of these discus. I hope it's coming through on his iPhone. Look at the quality of them. Beautiful. Look at this. Beautiful, flawless. He always kept beautiful discus, but this is, he outdid himself. This is albino pigeon discus, albino Marlboro, red and white discus. This is beautiful. Leopard discus. Very large discus in there with some corridors. You can't see the corridors because the discus are so big, they're blocking the view. Look at that. Gorgeous. He keep himself some discus. Got some little baby ghost knife in here. John Daniels. All right. More discus. Okay, so they got Gorda River rainbows here. I got some of them at home in my fish room. That's why I know them. Millennium rainbows here. I guess this is a turquoise rainbow, not showing much color. You can see those Gorda River rainbows are pretty expensive. A turquoise also. More discus. He got more discus than you can handle in here. Oh, look at that. Tigrinus. You got a Tigrinus catfish back there. Only 280. You're damn right it's rare. Look at that. Tigrinus catfish. I'm very tempted to buy this catfish, but I didn't come here to buy. I came here to just look. Oh, these discus are beautiful. Their color is beautiful. Albino snakeskin discus, $145. They're expensive, but they're gorgeous. I have never seen these colors before on the discus. Okay, some more blue diamond discus. This is beautiful. All right, you see, we got some silver arowanas, and look, we got some albino silver arowanas. Rare, you don't see those in local fish shops around here for real. So he's really trying to do his thing. And $200, which is a fair price for their size, fair price, especially when you consider you know, ordering some for $140, $150, $165, $180, and then paying shipping and everything like that, put them through the stress of shipping and all that. Why do all that when you just come in here and get one for $200? I'm tempted to get one of these as well to grow out another one. I'm trying to be a responsible fish keeper because I don't want to, you know, I already got two large arowanas at home. But the truth is that I really want another albino. But hey, let me fight it. Let me fight it off. Assorted angels. I'm very curious as far as what kind of angels these are right here. I wish I knew because I like to steal a good deal when I find one. Sometimes he have more than what he know he have. And I like to be the recipient of that. They're good looking angels, very healthy. Aqua Funk, he told me what to look for in angelfish when he did his video. See, make sure their fins are intact, they're not hiding in the back. Like that one back there hiding, that's what he was talking about. You don't want one that's hiding. You want their fins to be erect, like this one and hanging out in the front. See that? That's what you want. I've been watching. This is what I'm talking about. Sometimes he have stuff and he don't know what they are, so he just got angelfish, $10. And I'm quite sure that these angelfish would be more expensive if he knew what they were. Aqua Funk, take a good look at this, brother. Tell me what they are. Leave a message, let me know what kind of angelfish these are so that I can come back and steal some if it's if they were stealing. They're $10 each. Aqua Funk, when I post this, brother, I need you to leave a message, let me know what they are, and if $10 for these, what you call a steal, they're larger than quarter size for $10. Somebody tell me what these are. Are they Montezuma? Because, again, we don't know what kind of swordtails they are. Let me know if they're Montezuma swordtails and if I need to be stealing these as well. Look like that. He might be selling them for $8. What kind of sword tails are they? I might get them just on general purposes. Look at them. Are they Montezuma? I don't know enough about sword tails, but I know from what I've seen, Montezuma have some very long sword tails run the length of their body, and that's what it looks like. Alright, y'all. Hey, real quick before I forget, look at these African cichlids. Quite a display. He got a lot of, I'm trying to keep those kids out of it, they keep running around. He got a lot of different variety in here. Beautiful. Beautiful. Oh my goodness. And he's always kept a lot of African cichlids as well. One day I think I'm going to keep an African cichlid tank. Frontosa right there. I believe that's Venustis. This is gorgeous. Gorgeous. All right, those of you who are on the African cichlids, I believe these are beautiful sulfur-head cichlids. I've never heard of them. I don't know what I'm looking at, but I know that the color is outstanding. Oh my God, this beautiful. Look how the tangerine color on the heads. It is gorgeous. Oh. Beautiful. I'm loving them. Beautiful. Over here we got a flagtail petrolidus. I don't know if he's saying that he wants $140 for it. I know they are expensive, especially when they get some size. But I would hate to imagine how much mine would cost if I was selling it. Wolfish. Uh-oh. I see Terra's Gold Song. $40 though, I don't know, man. I want one. I do. I want one. I even see the one that I want. I don't want to spend $40 though. You look good. I might have to pass on them. Don't want to spend $40. Actually, I don't want to spend anything. But I don't want to spend $40. You look damn good though. I know exactly which one I want. because I figured out how to tell the males from the female. The one all the way back at the bottom is a male, and it's because his dorsal fin extend beyond his tail fin. There he is, front and center. He seems to be the boss. He act like, oh, somebody just bit him. That female just straightened him out real quick. That was funny. Very tight. All right, so you got some spotted guard. They are for 40. You got an ornate bison in there. Oh, had an ornate bison. I guess he sold it. But this royal clown knife. Look at the size of that royal clown knife for $75. Are you serious? They sell them half that size for twice that price. I'm serious. I have seen them online at about 6 inches for $150. This thing is almost as wide as the long as the glass is wide. He looked like a 12-incher. 12-incher for $75. This is, oh my God. Yep, let's make a deal. Look at him. Like I said, sometimes you just don't know what he got. Sometimes it work out for you, sometimes it don't. But while we at it, y'all, hey. Like I told y'all, there was yellow jacket, baby yellow jacket, cichlids. This is where I got them at for $5 each. And it is a consensus that they are not yellow jacket. The consensus is that they are some type of Ampelophis species. And apparently, he don't know what they are, but they were only $5 each, so I'm not gonna fret too bad. I bought 6 of them, that's $30. So what, we'll keep them, we'll grow them out, and see what they turn into. Might luck up and get something that I wanna keep. But it's, hey, $30 investment in the 6 fish, I'm not gonna flip out about it. I think they're so cheap because they don't really know what they are. I guess some customer brought them in and just said, hey, take a bunch of babies off me. Oh my goodness. Now this royal clown knife is absolute. Look at his markings. That's what I'm talking about. Look at those markings. $75, that is a steal. Look at those markings. Stop trying to trick me, Spotted Gar. I know better. I'm never getting another one you ever again. You guys are crazy dinosaur maniacs. You guys are stone cold killers. I had one. I know what y'all do. Y'all bite everything for no reason at all. Nope. Won't do it. But look at that knife fish. Awesome.
All right. This one is labeled bicolor peacock. And this was Ali Blue Peacock. And this is Sapphire Cichlid, I'm not sure.
But I don't know my Africans, I'm sorry.
Let's move on over here. Sand divers.
Sand divers and flame tail.
Assorted Trophius. I'm just trying to show love to the African cichlid lovers.
Assorted Chromis. I'm just trying to show love to you guys because some of you guys look at my channel as well. I'll get into Africans at some point in time, I guess.
Flower horn. Hold on, let me pause. Nice. Look at next to my hand so y'all can get a reference for size. This is a watermelon plecar. Hey, buddy. Yeah, let us see you. Come on, let us see you. That's a watermelon plecar. He wanted $135 for it. Watermelon plecar. What you guys think?
Think I should come back and get it? I've been thinking about it. It's a nice size.
Black tip of chula that's back there. And yes, they are priced at $140. The flag tip of chulas I have is 3 times that size, so I hate to imagine what that would cost.
Funny enough, I bought my flag tip of chula this from Aaron at his old shop. So So the flagtail petulas that y'all see in my big predator tank, I got from him a couple years ago, and he was, when I bought him, I think he was a good 4 inches. And I think I bought him for like $25 or $30. Sorry, I had to jump down here real fast. Show y'all, look at how cute these little Inla Kerry Bishas are. $75. They are cute. Hey! The Inla Kerry Bisha that I have in my big predator tank was even smaller than this when I bought it. I think I got it for $50 or $55, but it was smaller than this. They're so cute. Yeah, my Bisha, most of my Bishas, they still had their external gills when I purchased them. Because, you know, Bishas, they have external gills until they mature and grow out of them, just like water dogs and so forth. Frontosas, blue Kipili, $110. Frontosa, look at them. They're good looking fish. I like frontosas, especially the black widow. Pretty large frontosa. He won $150 for this one, and he's in there with albino dolphins and blue dolphins. Somebody's food. There's the albino dolphins and the blue dolphins. And he's trying to tempt me with these red-tailed giant garamis for only $30. What y'all think? They get huge, and he's going to take up a lot of space. And in order for me to grow one of these out, realistically, once it gets the size to go in my predator tank, I'm going to have to take out one or two of the fish that I already have in there, just because these guys get so huge, it's going to take up so much space and create so much bio load on the tank. I would have to make a sacrifice because these things, like I said, they get big, produce a lot of waste. They get huge. For $30, oh my God. Leave a comment what you guys think about that. What do you know, y'all? My camera is up and running again because I got a power stick that charged it while I was filming with my phone. So I'm going to try to film as much as I can with my camera so I can get quality looks at these fish. Hey, you know what? Hold tight. I got to go back to that one little flower horn and get him in real color. This little guy here. Hey, buddy. I'm in love with this. Look at this. Got to be picking up. Look at him. He comes straight to the camera. Comes straight to the glass. Look at him. Hey, man. Hey. Look at this. Look how interactive he is. Look at how much personality. Look at his face. He's beautiful. Look at his colors, y'all. Sorry, I'm trying to catch him. Look at his finnage. Oh, my God. This is a beautiful fish. It is. This little guy's $130. He is a keeper for sure. Look at him. Man. Ooh, he's beautiful. I don't need any more flower horns though. If I did, he would be the one. Oh my God. Believe it or not, the big fella that I got in the tank, divided off with rose gold, used to look like this, if not more beautiful. For real. I don't know what the hell happened to, because I bought him from Aaron at his other shop as well. Aaron do have some beautiful quality flower horns. Oh my goodness, look at them. Look at these gold psalms. Gold psalm green terrace. And a tank full of ruby red peacocks. They're $30 each. They're some good looking fish. I think I would get down. I think I'm gonna have to get into this African cichlid gang. Now tell me what you think. Some OBs, tank full of OBs, $25. You got a bunch of them, gang load of them. All right, y'all, big red tail catfish. Here's a silver eye one. So this is another display tank. You got gar, King Kong parrot. That's a huge flower horn. That's a, oh, that Mayan cichlid is looking good. It's coming along.
Look at that huge flower horn he added in here. Oh my goodness. Man, he's risky. He put flower horns up in here with his fish, and last week he had a Trimac in here for a while with some jaguars. But that Mayan was looking chewed up. And now he's looking like he's coming to a point where he might be worth something. I want me a Mayan cichlid, but I already know that he's going to, oh, price is $115. Nope, don't want to spend $115. I'd rather grow one out myself so I can know exactly how old you are and have an idea how long I can expect to keep you. But he got some big parrots, King Kong parrots, red mammon. So he got red mammon in here, $350 and $250. He got jumbo and then extra, extra large and yellow mammon. Okay, so they're mammons. Either that or he's just using that term. Got a couple of flagtail petrolidus in here. The arowana is not camera shy. Redtail catfish, look at him. Huge, put my hand up next to him so y'all can see. Huge. Look at this. Hand against the glass. Huge. So the redtail catfish, I don't see a price on that. Maybe he's not selling them. I can do me a Mayan, but I'm not into parrot fish. It's a very few hybrid fish that I'm into. Flower horns I love. And I can't believe this Mayan is chasing the flower horn away. Well, maybe it's because he just added that flower horn and the flower horn is not feeling himself yet. Oh, he just turned the table on him. Okay. It's a big boy. Oh my God. Look at this little pimp. This little joker got a nuchal hump already. And he's tiny. And he got a nuchal hump. And he got black in him. Oh my, look at his markings. Look, dude. Hey, man, look at his markings. Beautiful. Look at that. Let's take a look at you. Attitude. Look how small he is, and he got a nuchal hump. I'm impressed. I really am. Look at him. He's $120. I think this is a future showstopper right here. Attitude, moxie. Look at him. Confident. Come to the glass. Not afraid of the camera. Then you got this little flower horn in here giving him hell. Look at him. He's in there with the red borle, and he's giving them all they can handle and more. Look, he don't know who he want. He just want to be the boss. African scats, and they just chase each other around all day. He wants $75 each for those little guys, but you gotta set up a brackish water tank. Okay. Got a Buenos Aires tetra there. Well, fish family, there you have it. That concludes this video. This is my first store tour video. I hope you guys like it. I hope you enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed going there to that fish store. I'm going to do a part two because I did not show any of the saltwater section. So I'm going to go back out there and do a part two. I didn't do that part two because I had ordered a filter for my camera lens to filter out all that blue light and everything, so you guys can get a good look of the natural color of the fish, especially on that saltwater side, because they got a lot of blue light. Well, let me speed this along. I am doing water changes in here, so don't mind the hose hanging from the tank and the lights out and all that good stuff. I'm multitasking, which is good for me. All of you who have not subscribed by now, please do consider subscribing. When you subscribe, what you're doing, you're supporting the channel, and you're drawing attention to this channel. So when people are looking for content and everything, YouTube will hopefully suggest this channel and hopefully interest someone else to join this family and take this ride with us. And of course, I'm going to continue doing my very best to keep you guys interested, try to show you beautiful fish, try to share information with you guys, and we all grow together. Like I said, I'm no expert, I'm no genius, but I'm just sharing my hobby with you guys, and I hope you guys love it. If you don't subscribe, I hope you do subscribe, but please also consider leaving a like, leaving a suggestion, any comments, any questions, anything like that. I do read all the comments because I'm ecstatic to hear from you guys. I'm excited when you guys participate. That's what I'm doing this for. Okay, and again, subscribing don't cost you anything. You can unsubscribe at any time, but just go ahead and subscribe, join this family, join this ride with us, and we can grow and enjoy the journey together. Until then, y'all, happy fish keeping. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.